He is playing tough out there. He leads 2-1 in the third set.
A game to one, Heidi leads.
And there's our situation on 16 as Jimmy Connors continues to warm up at the stadium. The crowd filing in now and finding their seats because there is no bigger attraction in all of tennis than that man you're looking at right there, James Scott Connors. We'll be back after these words from your local stations.
Jimmy Connors and Terry Tolan. As Brent said a minute ago, 3-4 years ago, Tolan was one of the most highly regarded prospects anywhere in the world, not just in France. Somehow it's never developed.
Well, he was the world junior champion in 1980. He won the Swedish Open in Båstad in 81. But he's really been overshadowed by Noah, LeConte, and Forget, and has really sort of not had the kind of career they thought. He made some money early, apparently, on some endorsements and things, and perhaps things came a little too quickly. Connors to serve. Toulon, 22 years of age, living in Paris, ranked 87th.
Connors will be 33 tomorrow. He alluded to the fact a minute ago that there were a lot of people who didn't think that he was still capable of winning this tournament. He is not among those people. He thinks he can.
That's any indication we're going to be here a while. We're going to have some very good rallies. Toulon is really a clay court specialist.
15 all. Just started. Go back and keep a record, Tony, of all the times we've seen Connors play and the shot that he misses most often. It was that one he just missed right there.
The low forehand volley, because he has sort of a flat face on the ball. He doesn't lay it open and cut it a little bit. And also that forehand approach shot into the net has been a bugaboo for him. And, you know, we're talking about a guy that's really had a lousy career. He's only won Wimbledon twice. He's only won here five times, won the Australian Open, won the Masters. Jimmy Connors won 105 tournaments. So he's kept a lot of people from getting to that side enough to win all those matches. Players have only played once. Connors won that particular time.
Yeah. advantage Connors.
Here's another look, and you see some smoke right there, the passing shot. Toulon actually not in a bad position, but it just went by him before he could react.
It's the first game of the first set.
Good to be on the dead run that far behind the baseline and top that backhand cross court.
I was just noticing, Tony, how far Toulon is standing behind the baseline, and especially to return Connor's serve, which isn't a very hard serve.
He wants to take a full swing at the ball. He brushes it a lot, meaning it's extra topspin and doesn't always get good speed on it.
And he takes an extra step backwards and he returns it too. But really, to play and win on this particular surface, you can't play that far behind the baseline. You can on clay, where it's much slower, a much slower bounce, but that's sort of a defensive position you're in back there.
Won't see too many of those.
Deuce.
Ace by Connors.
Standing that far back, I think we're going to see Jimmy do more of that.
Advantage Connors.
And particularly if you're going to hit under the ball, slice it so it stays up a little bit more.
From Leeds, England, is the umpire. The object of that scornful look.
Game Connors.
Took sort of a funny bounce.
Took some time. Connors wins it. One game to love.
First game.
Pat Summerall here with Tony Trabert and John Newcomb. And Tony, you look at Connors and Toulon, you think realistically Toulon has a chance?
No.
Thank you. Newcomb, what about your opinion?
You can't win on this surface when you stay that far behind the baseline. You have to play on the baseline and you have to look for the short ball and come to the net. You just cannot play all defensive type of tennis. No, I mean, that last forehand we saw, I've never seen such a big swing on a low ball. He was a great player a few years ago, Terry Toulon, and everybody thought he was going to be a coming champion. I don't know where he got off the track.
Us on clay, though, not on a fast court, really.
Earlier, Terry Toulon talked about playing Jimmy Connors, about the pressure playing on center court. You start thinking that, hey, look, he's a lot better than I am. I guess Tony's answer was pretty objective.
Well, it's a form sport.
Well, please,
the better player wins the majority of the time anyway, and there's question that Jimmy Connors is a better tennis player than Terry Toulon. But if they get those good rallies like that, that'll be good for Jimmy. You know, he likes to stay back and hit a lot of balls.
There's one he won't hit.
15 love.
When Terry came onto the tennis scene and was doing so well a few years ago, there's a final score.
Berger beats Teacher in four sets and now plays Yannick Noah.
I guess it was about 3 or 4 years ago, Tony, and he got some unbelievable contracts from racket manufacturers and for wearing shoes and clothing and that. enormous amounts of money at a very young age. And probably for shots like that.
40 love.
40 love.
Well, there are those that feel that he did, those things came to him so quickly that he just sort of quit working and rode the crest of the wave for a while and just has not improved his game.
Toulon evens at one apiece over in the grandstand. Yvon Lindell has begun. He leads two love over De La Pena. If form holds, Connors and Lindell could meet in the semifinals.
Corrected call.
Connors thought the ball was out.
The linesman called out and then corrected his call. And because of that, they're going to replay the point.
All right. 15 love.
Women's third round score, Gombert.
She advances. She plays the winner of Zena Garrison and Belinda Cordwell, who play tonight.
40 love.
40 love. Earlier, Yannick Noah advanced here in the stadium, as did Martina Navratilova.
Game Connors.
2-1, Connors leads in the first set.
He leads 2-1.
A lot of topspin on that backhand, and that's the one of the problems when you come in to try to drive that ball with so much spin on it, you can easily lose control of it, as Jimmy just did on the last backhand.
Are people diving around 15, on this cement 13? Surface like it's grass or trampoline or something? That's got to hurt.
Well, we were watching a film yesterday, Pat. We had of young German kids being coached, and they were actually on a vaulting mat on the floor. Coach throwing the ball to them. They were diving across, hitting volleys, and then going into a Boris Becker-type roll. They were being coached to do that.
Double break point.
When you play with as much topspin as Toulon is, you have to try to keep good depth on the ball, and most of the shots that he hit in that last rally were landed really short.
Yeah. 30-40.
That's the trouble with the excessive topspin, is that the ball tumbles quickly and will fall short in the court. Not a bad serve. That's the first one for Toulon.
It's two in a row, the first serve. He's really hammered.
They list him as 5'10". He looks a little taller than that to me.
Set.
Advantage Connors.
Double fault. First one of those for Toulon.
That's how he got here. Five setter in the first round, four setter in the second round, though it hadn't been easy.
Three games to one. Third round, men's singles.
Three games to one.
Jimmy over for a towel. U.S. Open match victory leaders, Vic Satius. 75 wins. Jimmy Connors is second. Bill Tilden third. Connors going to tie Satius.
15
love. Roy Victor, my old doubles partner, Davis Cup mate. Perfect day to play tennis. Not much breeze at all. It's not very warm.
A few clouds scattered around, but certainly an ideal day.
Situation 7-5-6-2 back in 1982. A lot of things have happened since then.
Seems like yesterday.
Surprising that they haven't played since 1982.
Really is, yes.
That's February 82.
That's the only time they've played.
Well, Jimmy doesn't play in many of the clay court tournaments, and Toulon doesn't play in many of the fast surfaces, so. They didn't have many opportunities, obviously.
Seats, but the second one couldn't get to it. Connors leads four games to
Connors
one first set.
Four games to one.
Connors 4-1. Jimmy seated number four. His opponent is Terry Toulon. Lindell also in command over in the grandstand. He's up 5-1. Connors is up 4-1.
Love.
Jimmy's seated at number four, Tony. That'll be the lowest ranking he's had here since 1974.
Yep.
It's his match record at the U.S. Open, his 16th appearance. 74-10, trying to tie the record held by Vexatious for match victories. Looking straight down. That serve just missed.
Man. 13-15.
Might have heard Connor say hit it like a man. Billy Nastassi.
Out.
Pancho Segura, one of the most popular guys to ever lift a tennis racket.
Longtime coach and advisor, Jimmy Connors. Yvonne Lindell in the grandstand has won the first set 6-1. Took him 23 minutes. Connors has been at it with Toulon 34 minutes. Jimmy leads 4-1. Game to Toulon.
Connors leads 4-2.
It was a good smash. It was a fairly deep lob.
Connors trying to go ahead 5-2. First set, it's 40 love.
Head. Out. 40, 15.
Double fault, first one by Connors. Loves New York, loves to play in front of these New York crowds.
He can get him stirred up, too.
I think they get him stirred up as well.
You
really have to keep your concentration against a player like Tulane because the ball's coming back with so much spin all the time. Top spin, slice, never a flat ball coming to you. You would imagine that as long as Jimmy keeps his concentration, which I'm sure he will, he would have no problem in this match. That's the slice. Another slice.
Two in a row, those he missed.
He's hit the tape on the top of the net both times.
Now I'm wondering if Tulane might try to get more slice backhands to Jimmy's forehand side, because when he hits the topspin over there, the topspin causes the ball to bounce high. And Connors doesn't mind the high bouncing ball on the forehand. It's the low bouncing ball that gives him more trouble. And you get that by hitting slice.
Well, from 40 love, it's now break point for Tulane.
That's how easy you can let it slip, a double fault. Two balls into the top of the tape.
You see Jimmy there mishits the ball and it comes over just barely clear the net. And he ends up fouling into the open court. A very, very fortunate Jimmy Connors. He could have lost his serve there. So it's a deuce. Another break point for the Frenchman.
That second last forehand he hit was a beauty, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. High and looping, landed just inside the baseline. Very tough to play when someone hits topspin at you and gets good depth.
On the serve now.
In his third round of the U.S. Open of 1985. Tulane about to serve. Let's go down to Brent Musburger.
Pat, I'm with Eon Tyriac, who is the manager of the phenomenal Boris Becker. And Eon, how is Becker handling the mounting pressure here at Flushing Meadow in this U.S. Open?
Well, how he says, I think he was born twice. He was born on the final day of Wimbledon. He was born on his chronological day when he was born. I think since he learned a lot of things, more the time goes by, he's learning more. And I think that from his point of view, the most difficult decision is that every day he has to say no to more people than he desires to say.
We are watching the man who probably handles the pressure of this tournament better than anybody, and you would have to agree, Jimmy Connors, who is up a game here in the first set. A lot of folks, Eon, have said to me, Connors against Becker would make the greatest final we could have. All that raw emotion and everything. Would they match up well against each other?
Well, I think with all respect for Jimmy Connors, he is the biggest competitor in sports I ever saw in my life, and that's to say a lot because I play Olympics in hockey and there's a lot of competition there. But Jimmy Connors, I think, would have been very good in any sport, and he is the guy who probably would give his the last drop of energy in each match that he ever played. Now, you have to agree that probably is not the Jimmy Connors that he was 5 years ago, but he's still probably 95 or 98% of that one, and that makes him the player that he is today.
Yeah, let me quickly ask you, as we go back to Pat, about Toulon of France, the young man who has not matured and recognized his potential. Could he stage an upset here this afternoon? Does he have that kind of talent against Jimmy?
Well, I think that is going to be difficult because though the French, they have the pattern to play Jimmy, you know, since he lost to Roger Vasselin in that quarterfinal in Roland Garros, everybody knows, just slice it to Jimmy's forehand and wait there, but the court here is much faster, and I think that Jimmy can handle. Jimmy played in this court probably for 100 times. Toulon is very new to this court, and doesn't matter one, at least in the paper, Jimmy is going to be much stronger than Toulon.
What a magnificent shot by the five-time champion. Eon, thank you very much for being with us. Good luck to you and Boris Becker. You're doing a great job with the young man. Upstairs now to Pat Summerall. What a shot by Connors, Pat.
What a point. That's the best point of the match.
This is the another closet shot that Connors gets away with. The one-hander down the line, and he raises his clenched fist, and he's 30-15, serving it 4-all in the first set. Interesting how a match can change. Connors is cruising along at 4-2 with a break, 40 love on his serve, and all of a sudden he lost his serve, and now he's in a dogfight.
40-15, 4-all.
Correction, the ball was on the line.
Umpire Steve Wynyard overruling the out call, so they play a let. Bad break for Connors, really, because he was in the driver's seat. Would have had a very simple volley. Especially on this surface, if you want to try that drop volley, you better make it perfect, and that was perfect.
Connor's taking a little extra time now to make sure this one doesn't get away from him.
Game
first set. to serve 4-5 first set. Jimmy Connors won on grass, clay, and on cement. The only player ever to accomplish that. Just watch that one go by.
15.
Third ace. Fourth. Sorry.
13-15.
Down goes Connors.
Well, that's pretty 14, good speed on that serve, I'd say, huh?
Yep.
I think the spin fooled him completely.
Wife Patty.
It's 40-15. Talon about to pull even at 5.
He's mad now. I think he's more mad with himself when he thinks of 4-2, 40 love, and
yep,
had a chance to, you know, just about close the set out, and here I am now in a real struggle.
Great return, good serve. Let's go to Pat O'Brien. Hand grenade overhead.
Hand grenade. Interesting, that was a calculated return of serve there from Toulon. A sliced forehand return to Connors' forehand. Really whips the racket head through, doesn't he, Tony, on the backhand side? Tremendous racket head speed.
Yep. He brushes up the back of the ball a lot, which, again, creates a lot of topspin. Sometimes you don't get much pace. So he's hit a lot of them with a lot of pace as well.
Good shot
to line made.
It is, and it's good to see he's starting to think more than in the beginning of the match. He was just hitting tennis balls. Now he's really mixing it up well with some slices and top spins, short balls, deep balls.
Yeah, that slice was short. That's what made it effective onto the two-handed side. 40-30.
Connors, and he leads 6-5 in the first set. We'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local station.
On the first point.
Good way to get even quickly.
15-4.
Levon Lindell cruising right along over in the grandstand. That too, a third round men's singles match.
This could be a pretty interesting tiebreak if it goes into one. Coming into the net here, and a pretty good lob from Jimmy right over the backhand side, which is of course more effective. Coming in now. Good example there. Turning a defensive position into an offensive position by the use of the lob.
Double set point for Connors. Exactly 1 hour. Still a set point. That's where Toulon would like to get one of those big boomers in.
Good. Went for a three-quarter pace one, didn't he?
A struggle, but Connors wins the first set, 7-5.
Seven games to five. Hold your seats, please. Play continues. Second set.
Here is Jimmy's draw. LeCunt, Edberg. Assuming he gets by Toulon. Just to update the score between Heinz Gundhardt and Heidi over on court 16. That's been a good match.
Yeah, Gundhardt just hanging in there, right? Just has to love down, and he won the third in a tiebreak.
15-4.
Tiebreaker score was 8-6, by the way.
That's going close to the precipice, isn't it?
Isn't it?
Thirty.
Connors Edberg, if Connors wins this, should be an interesting match. He beat Edberg handily 2 weeks ago in Canada, but Edberg beat him pretty easily in Memphis earlier in the year.
Looking shot.
I just say, didn't think much of that stroke. Trying to just block it and float it deep.
First serve.
Also a little unusual. Connors wins the first game of the second set.
First game, second.
Jimmy Connors won the first set 7-5, each one love in the second. Terry Chulon serving in the second set.
Love 15.
Checking some of the other scores.
Edberg in four sets over Brad Gilbert. Jay Berger over Brian Teacher in four sets. That'd be a big thrill for Jay, the fourth round of the U.S. Open.
Yannick Noah in straight sets over Vitas Gerulaitis earlier. He'll play Jay Berger next. Henri Leconte in straight sets. Steffi Graf over Ann White.
She's a solid player, Steffi Graf. You like the way she plays, Newt?
I was very impressed.
Out.
We
were sort of talking about that yesterday, Tony. Martina had a very easy win. Steffi Graf, only 16 years of age. It seems like she's been around for years. Talking about what the Women's Tennis Association has voted to watch out for the burnout of young players.
One game.
Terry has played a lot better than I thought he'd play on this kind of a surface. Being a clay court specialist, I didn't think he could stay this close to Connors.
I thought Jimmy might be coming into the net more, but the few times he has advanced, he's been passed with some great passing shots.
Love 15.
That's his second double fault. Kate Gombert advances. Alicia Moulton, three sets.
Missed it.
Love 30.
Lindqvist over Thompson.
She has nice strokes.
She'd better. She plays Martina in the next round.
15-30.
Yvonne Lindell playing over in the grandstand and having what appears to be a rather easy time.
Red!
Out. Out.
Break point. That was a good forehand from Connors then, because he was forced way back behind the court, got it back very deep.
Manuela Maleva won the first set.
Thank you.
Do you ever think you'd see a top-seeded player from Bulgaria, Drape?
No. I never thought I'd see this many people in a tennis stadium either.
Well, they keep breaking records every day. Expect overall.
Yes, a little lucky, get away with it. Your memory must be going, Tony Kravitz.
Advantage. 1954
Davis Cup, sorry. Sydney, Australia, 25,000 people.
I remember
you
that.
You were playing in it, don't you remember?
I do remember. I was awfully nervous.
Second set after winning the first 7-5.
Gotta let those bounce.
Lob 50.
Defensive lob that high, coming down real fast. It's gonna pass your racket face very quickly. You let her bounce and come back up the second time. It's coming down more slowly, easier to judge.
We saw Noah throw a couple of those up against Gerolaitis earlier, and we're talking about how very few players do it. Connors is one of the players who does it very effectively.
While the point is in play.
Oh!
15 hole.
In that rally.
15-30.
Here's the high lob. This time Connors elects to let it bounce. Notice his weight moving back and then into the smash. Now coming in and moving very quickly to get that low volley.
Pretty good touch too. Unforced error department. Connors 17 and Toulon 7.
15-30.
15-40. 15-40. Connors leads 2-1 in the second set.
That was the fifth double for the Frenchman.
Interesting that that double fault would come up after the long rally, too. Wonder if he was a little winded. If he was, he should have taken just a little bit of extra time before he served.
That'll give him some time to rest.
30, 40.
Fifth ace.
Game Connors.
Connors moves up 3-1.
He leads 3-1.
Trouble City there with that attempt at a drop volley hit on the service line. Connors went right at him.
That'll take care of your sinus problems.
If you can, you try to hit it actually on their forehand side, tied in on the body rather than the backhand.
Right.
Toulon almost made that.
You go at the right hit in those close situations if he's a righty.
Love 15.
Almost impossible to hit a forehand volley from that position, and you're forced to try to hit a backhand volley from the wrong side.
Well, the good players all defend with the backhand volleying position. They can cover way out to the side and all the way across in front of their body.
That's a...
I was just thinking, Tony, we're going to have a lot of club players now go out tomorrow morning and start smashing their opponents in the right hip and say, Tony Trabert and John Newcomb told me it was okay. That's sportsmanship.
There are the unforced errors now 19-7. Triple break point for Toulon.
It's like a similar situation to the first set.
Right.
Jimmy seems to have his man down, and then Toulon keeps coming back.
Fifteen, 40. 30, 40.
Here's another look. Good depth there by Connors. There's his bread and butter, the two-hander. He got it pretty deep down the middle, no angle. Bingo, off goes the volley. So he saved two break points. He's still facing another one at 30-40.
And the last service game he had, he was down a break point, too.
Yep.
So he's really having to fight hard out here.
In the second set. Out. Jimmy Connors won the first set 7-5. He's up 3-2 in the second.
Second set. Law 15. 15 all.
It's interesting to me what good contact Connors makes, even on a ball like that stretched out. He really catches the middle of the racket at a lot of pace on it.
Oh. 15-30.
The ball hit the line.
Went way up into the stand. Right into a lady's hand. She stood up and she dropped it. She was so mad with herself.
Take another look, and you'll see Tuan,
15-40.
When he hits his shot, he stops. He doesn't try to recover. He's going out the other way. He thinks, I got no chance. Now he says, whoa, I got a chance to get there. Racket ready just as he arrives and misses it long. Had he tried to get back a little sooner, he might have had a decent play on that. So he's down double break point.
He's doing a lot of running in this match, isn't he?
Yep.
Remarkable return again by Connor.
Game Connors.
Awfully good reflexes by the Frenchman, but Connors gets a break.
Good pickup here on the first one. Falling down, getting up very quickly. Another remarkable volley from Tulane. And another one straight at him again.
The right hip.
That was at the right hip, wasn't it?
Matter of fact, it hit him in the right hip. That's a perfect example of what we're talking about. You can't get the racket to that position near your body.
Connor serving at 4-2, second set.
Three breaks in a row.
We have to get to line in a flak suit if that continues at the net.
After Connors won that last point of the last game, he gave it the double clench, fists up in the air, and
trying to pump himself up.
Well, he realizes he's in a tough situation out here. Chilana's not making many unforced errors at all, and He's having to earn every point he gets.
30 love.
Second ace for Connors.
It's a lot tougher than I thought it was going to be at 4-2, 40-love in the first set.
Hazing Nuke as far as he's played behind the base. But he's been able to hang in there like he did.
Well, he wants to take a full swing at the return like he just did there. And being back for it, you have more time. And, of course, Connors does not come in much behind his head.
So he's giving him the breathing room to stand back
right
there.
Number six in the double fault department.
It's unusually high for him.
I think every one of them just about has landed in the net, too. He used to be tossing the ball a little low.
Shalane again did a lot of running on that point.
13 all. Game Connors.
Game to Connors. He goes up 5-2 in the second set. He won the first set.
Connors leads 5-2, second set.
Chillon to serve at 2-5 in the second set. Jimmy Connors, number four seed, won the first set 7-5. Tomorrow our coverage again begins at 12:30 Eastern Time. McEnroe against Thomas Smith. Chris Everett Lloyd against Robin White. And Boris Becker against Joachim Nystrom. That ought to be reason. Remember that great match they had at Wimbledon?
Sure do. And Nystrom was serving for the match 5-4 in the fifth, and then again at 6-5, and got beat either 9-7 or 10-8 in the fifth set.
Fifteen all.
Shot on this particular surface.
15.
Particularly 13. If you do it back by the baseline or deeper.
Let's have a look where he's actually standing when he plays this drop shot.
He's right on the baseline.
Yeah.
Ball has to travel too far and it's going slowly. And that's what happens.
Second set.
Hit! 15-40
double fault.
That's number six. I made a mistake earlier. It's Connors has served three doubles, and that's the sixth double fault by Toulon.
Game in second set, Connors, six games to two. Full change.
6-2 Connors in the second set. Let's go over and pick up the action in the grandstand.
Half volleys, he's playing a little bit loosely, and he won those first two sets so easily that that's his biggest problem at the moment.
Lendl has broken service once here in the third set, and he's serving now, leading 4-3.
From the back, De La Peña looks a lot like Guillermo Vilas. I think people walk in here and say, wait a second, is that Vilas?
Same well, country. 15. Not a whole lot known about De La Peña. He is ranked 57th, 19 years of age. A lot known about Lendl, and De La Peña is learning a lot more than he wants right now. 6-1 in the first, 6-1 in the second, and currently 4-3 here in the third.
Big first serve from Lendl. He does have that high toss, Vern. We talked about it earlier, but he throws that ball about a foot and a half higher than he needs to, and then he really catches it as the ball comes down.
That's his sixth ace of the match, 15-0. That's pretty much the way it's
30,
gone, Barry.
15.
Most of the last hour and 25 minutes.
Well, De La Peña really has a slice backhand that is easy to pick off. The ball floats a little bit. That time, Lendl had an easy backhand volley. Another big serve right down the middle.
40-15.
Seventh ace.
You try and guard against that as a left-hander because Lendl can spin that ball out high to your forehand, but De La Peña was leaning to the left that time and opened up the center service line. Another great volley from Lendl.
5-3, Von Lendl.
5-3.
His coach, Tony Roach, is sitting on the front row here in the grandstand court.
That's a guy that held Newcomb up for all those years with that great doubles team, I think.
That's exactly right.
Ball.
Again, if you look at De La Peña, even his service motion right about in there looks a lot like Vilas.
15 love.
Risky shot.
15 all.
Ball way down below the net. He likes to try and hit a very delicate drop volley off the touch. No way. The sweepers have been out behind Yvonne. Every time they change courts, Vern, the crew comes out to get all that sawdust off the court. Lendl uses a lot of sawdust. Keeps it in his right pocket and keeps bringing it out and putting it on the racket handle to keep it dry. Now there he tried a topspin forehand. He's
30.
Been very unsuccessful. There's our friend Tony Roach in the center with the baseball hat on. One of the all-time great doubles players and now coaching Yvonne Lendl.
That's a well-lived-in face. Hard to believe that he's past 40 now.
Oh.
That ages us all, Barry. 30-15.
30. Finally got a good backhand. Vernie sliced it the last time, then he tried to hit over it. That time he really came over it with a good topspin cross court. Caught Yvonne. Again, Lendl doesn't seem to be concentrating as well as he should. He's got this match very easily tucked away. Two sets to one, love up.
Report from the stadium is that Jimmy Connors just won the first game of the third set.
Yeah.
Solid forehand again. Lindell loves to run around. If you give him a chance, he'll move 30, around and hit 40. The forehand anytime rather than hit that backhand. Lindell taking a lot of extra time, straightens the strings. Clean winner.
Game, set, and match. Lindell.
Well, it's been a stroll in the park so far here at the U.S. Open for Yvonne Lindell. He wins in straight sets today, and that is his third consecutive straight set victory. Let's go to Brent Musburger.
All right, Vern, thank you very much. Let me set what we've got planned now for the rest of the day. Obviously, we will see the conclusion of the Jimmy Connors match out in the stadium. He is rolling toward another victory. And you will see live coverage of Boris Becker in action playing doubles today. He is up against the French team. Yannick Noah and Henry LeConte will be matched against him. And we will show you the conclusion of Becker's victory yesterday. We were unable to stay on the air. And in the third set, Becker went to a tiebreaker. We'll have that. Now, a couple other notes today. We have an amateur who has reached the round of 16. He is Jay Berger, the first amateur to do that since Aaron Krickstein a couple years ago. We'll be hearing from him. All of that is still ahead of us as we continue with our coverage of the U.S. Open here on CBS.
We are live at the 1985 U.S. Open Tennis Championships. Yvonne Lindell has just won in the straight sets, and he is standing by down on the grandstand court with our Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Vern, thank you. You said, first of all, congratulations. You said that if you don't get enough tennis, sometimes you go home and play tennis. You're going to go home and play tennis now?
No, it was the other way. You asked me if I'm getting enough tennis. I said, definitely, yes. If I feel I don't play enough, I would play at home. It's better than, you know, struggle long five sets.
What about this? An hour and 29 minutes, this match. Was that enough for you today?
I like it.
You like
I like it,
it
very much.
Why?
Just get it over, no pressure, you know, and go and work on my game at home if I feel like it.
You look a little lighter this year, and you're playing like you're lighter this year. What about that?
You know, last year I started the diet, and I was on it about 10 days by the end of the Open, and this year I'm full year on it, and I really feel good. I lost a little bit of weight. I used to be between 180 to 85. I'm 172 to 167, so it feels really nice.
You have a smile of confidence here. Is this the year of Yvonne Lindell?
I hope so. I would like to think so, you know. But I'm enjoying myself much more than I was last year before the Open. And I feel I played good throughout the year. And it was pleasure for me, not a hard work. And it's always enjoyable that way.
I know you have Pate Orizaga next, but you possibly could meet Noah in the quarters. What about Yannick?
I know you guys are keyed up on that on this match because I heard you talking about it on TV, but I'm going to worry about Pate and Izaga, and if I win that match, ask me about the match afterwards.
Okay. You're going to worry about Pate, you're saying?
Yes, definitely. I always worry about the next opponent.
All right. Thank you, Yvonne. Thank you. Let's go over to Pat Summerall. Pat?
And we're back in the stadium now, or looking down at Shea Stadium up at the top of your picture, and the stadium at the National Tennis Center where Jimmy Connors seems in control of this match against Terry Tolan. He is up 2-11 in the third set.
Didn't come in on much of a shot.
That's what he said. Didn't come in on that shot. 7-5 and 6-2 in the first two sets, Connors.
Grunt after the grunt didn't work for the shot.
Something like Tarzan.
And he's down a break point.
That's more like a karate match.
Jimmy's wife, Patty, hooking on.
Tolan gives us some nice grunts too, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah, he's got some world-class grunts.
That's
out.
2-1. Connors in the third set.
2-1.
He won the first two. Up 2-1 in the third set. He's won the first two sets. 7-5 and then 6-2 in the second.
You let that service break get away.
To bring you up to date on the other happenings around the National Tennis Center, that's the way it stands between Heinz Gunhardt and Heidi. They're going to the fifth set. The winner of that meets Henri Leconte, another of the Frenchmen.
That's something, that match being two sets all. At Gunhardt, two sets to lap down, won the third set in the 8-6 tiebreaker.
He's pulled even. Just
14,
wide.
15.
Great touch volleys in this match, Toulon.
Two games all.
One was a backhand drop volley, and that was on the forehand side.
A lot of clay court players are good at touch volleys, aren't they? They're not very good at the aggressive type of volley, but touch volleys, yes, and they're effective shots on clay.
Two games all, third set. Vic Satius holds the U.S. Open match victory record for men, this is, and Jimmy Connors is just one away from that and well on his way to tying Vic.
Like the Pete Rose countdown, you can start counting.
Connor's starting to come into the net a little more. It seems like every time the match gets tight, he starts to come into the net and he wins points. Makes me wonder why he hasn't done it more often throughout the match. Especially as we've pointed out before, with his opponent playing so far behind the baseline.
40-15.
Game to Connors.
Game to Connors. He leads 3-2 in the third set after having won the first two sets. That's the situation. Jimmy Connors leading Terry Talon. 2-0 and 3-2 in the third set. It hasn't been that easy, though. Although he is up 2-0, Jimmy's had to work.
And it's good for him. You get into the tournament more and deeper, and you want some reasonably tough matches. You don't want to be out there for 5 hours, but being pushed some and hitting a lot of balls will make you a little sharper for the next match.
15.
Sitting up here with us, with John Newcomb and Tony Trabert and me, is referee emeritus, the man who
13,
really made many, many great contributions to the game of tennis, Mike Blanchard. And if we have a situation arising that might involve a rules or a judgment, Mike is going to help us out.
Thank you, Pat.
Pleasure to have you, and thank you for joining us.
Mike and his wife Flo have been involved in the game for a long, long time, and never heard anybody sing but nice things about him. What a shot. I wonder why he doesn't beat more people.
Just to bring you and keep you up to date on the Gunhardt-Heidi match, Gunhardt has won the first game of the fifth set. That's third round action as well. We'll be covering the conclusion of that. Our coverage of the U.S. Open continues.
Look easy.
40 love.
Okay, well, that wasn't that easy a shot. Toulon made a terrific backhand. Connors is right there.
Casually, almost. 40 love.
Game to Connors.
He leads 4-3 in the third set now. He won the first two sets. In the third set. Won the first one 7-5, second one 6-2. Thierry Toulon serving. He's played well.
15-5.
Match now just over 2 hours old.
What a great mob.
On the line. Talk about great lob.
Wasn't that a super point?
30 love.
Well, that was just a super love from Jimmy, and now coming in and taking him. He usually wins these points. Very aggressive volley. So much topspin on that lob. Right on the line.
30-15.
Wasn't Connor's lob a good one? The way he came underneath it on the backhand and just floated it over Toulon's head.
Landed right on the line.
Toulon's grunt figured out.
You have?
He doesn't grunt every time he hits the ball. When he hits certain types of balls, he goes, hey-ya. But only on certain balls.
Connors was going to cover the other shot. He was covering the ball down the line.
30-40.
Not at home. And it's a break point for Jimmy.
That's a bad break for Toulon. He had the right shot. Tough point to lose that one. If he loses this game, Connors will be serving for the match.
Out. He is amazing the way he returns serve, Connors. There are balls you don't even think he can reach. That touch again. Meantime, over on the grandstand court, Boris Becker.
To the left of the chair.
Young phenom warming up and getting ready to play doubles.
Who's his doubles partner, Pat?
Slobodan Zivojinovic.
Slobodan Zivojinovic.
All right. Now spell it. It's like...
Partner from West Germany.
He's also known as Bobo.
Big Z, Big Zivo. We did a match over at Wimbledon. We called him Big Zivo. It's just too tough to pronounce his name.
He's the one who beat Mats Wilander in the first round at Wimbledon on center court.
Played a great match.
He's a good player. Big guy, really gives the ball a nudge.
Becker's a big guy.
I know, there should be a lot of hard balls hitting that doubles match. Toulon with a chance to level now at 4-4.
Ow!
Heidi, one all in the fifth. Seems like it's been going on ever since we've been on the air. It is now, we've just been informed, 2-1 Goodhart. Some comeback.
Heidi, sorry, Pat. Heidi's born in Buenos Aires. He's living in Spain now. Pretty noted as a clay court player. Toulon. First serve sort of deserting Toulon a little bit.
Shot that one. I don't think that'll go over very well with Jimmy.
4-4.
All games over.
In the third set. Steffi Graf will face Manuela Maleva.
That'll be a match.
Bergen. Yes,
that'll be a good match.
Two of the best up-and-comers.
Right, thank you.
4-4, third set.
Love.
Petila. Connors.
Game to Connors, and he leads 5-4 in the third set now. He's won the first two sets and is up 5-4 in the third set as he attempts to advance.
Foot fault on the second serve, so it's a double fault. It's a tough break.
Mats Wilander in the second set of his match yesterday got foot-faulted in the tiebreak on the second serve. Lost the tiebreak. Guess if you tread on the line, you're going to be foot-faulted.
Yeah. Carelessness, really.
Pretty risky shot. He really wasn't left with a lot of options, was
no.
he? It was a good shot from Connors.
Jimmy covered a lot of court that time and hitting it as hard as he can hit it. And he got that one down low. Terry doesn't know he's not ready to go yet. He was up ready to serve. Love 30, so Connors love two more points and get out of here.
Grunt against grunt.
And it's triple match point for Jimmy Connors, the number four seed.
This would be a real good workout for Connors. They've been on court almost 2 hours and 15 minutes. Had a lot of long rallies.
I think Toulon will be very pleased with his effort. He's played a good tennis match.
And that's
a good workout indeed for Jimmy Connors. White looks on. Match time 2 hours 13 minutes. And that ties Jimmy Connors with Vic Satius for the men's record of matches won in the U.S. Open. Let's go quickly to Brent Musburger.
All right, in that same bracket, Heinz Gunhardt now is closing in on a dramatic win. He has come back after trailing two sets to love. He has won two, and now he leads 4-1. He is in the fifth set, and of course, that is the longest match of the tournament so far. A baseball note, Pete Rose, 2-for-4 today. He is now within six hits of breaking Ty Cobb's all-time hit record. Jimmy Connors, Pete Rose, and now who knows? There's another hustler who could make some note for himself in the world of sports, and that, of course, is Boris Becker. We're going to check in on Boris next. We'll watch him play doubles live, and also we'll see that third set tiebreaker that he turned in yesterday's singles when we continue.
Pat O'Brien is standing by down on the stadium court with Jimmy Connors, and let's go down to Pat.
All right, Pat, thank you. You were saying it's a good workout. You like hitting these kind of balls, this many balls at this stage of the tournament.
Well, he played a little different than the first two matches I had. The first two guys that played had real big serves, and they tried to end the point pretty quick. He tried to keep a few balls in play. He hit with an awful lot of top spin, which is, in a way, is good for me. But I got to hit a lot of balls. I thought I hit the ball very well today, and I moved well and got to a lot of balls, so I'm pretty pleased the way things are going.
You tied Vic Satius's U.S. Open record today at 75. How do you feel about that?
Well, my job is nowhere near finished. It's nice to tie the record. I guess records are made to be broken along the way, I guess. And if I can continue playing and continue winning, then that would be even better.
Stefan Edberg is next. Your comments.
Well, we've played a number of times since he's come on the tour, and he's playing pretty well right now, and he's got a big serve, and he's volleying well, and he's moving the ball pretty well. But I go on and play the same. I guess his strength is into my strength. His serve's into my return. So once I get the ball in play, if I can get the ball in play and start the point off like that, then see what happens.
All right, congratulations, Jimmy. Happy birthday in advance, by the way.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's go to Brent Musburger. Brent.
All right, Pat, thank you very much. Far court.
Time. Right now, let's go down to Brent Musburger and Jimmy Connors.
All right, thank you very much, Pat. And another man who's celebrating a big day tomorrow will be Jimmy Connors. Happy birthday a day in advance,
James
Scott. Listen, have you ever played Boris Becker? Have you ever met?
No, never have. Practiced a little bit, actually, before the tournament started here, and then earlier in the year in Philadelphia, practiced a little while, but that's about it.
What'd you notice when you were practicing with him, Jimmy?
Well, he's big and strong, that's for sure. They're growing him big now. He's hitting the ball very hard. He hits the ball quite flat sometimes off his forehand. He has a variety on his backhand. He can come under the ball or come over it with some topspin. But he's big and strong and playing with not much pressure right now, so that gives him a little edge.
Pat just mentioned that he plays Nystrom tomorrow. What kind of a match can we expect there?
Well, if it's anything like the match they had at Wimbledon, it would be unbelievable. I think Nystrom served for the match twice in the fifth set at 5-4 and 6-5 before Becker eventually won. So if the match is, if that is a preview of what will follow tomorrow, that would be unbelievable.
I want to take a look at your match today, at least a point from it. And how did you feel, and how were you playing here, Jimmy?
Well, I thought I was playing very well today. It was a little bit kind of different match than I played the last two. I got to hit a lot of balls, and Toulon hits with a lot of topspin. The first two matches I played were not much rhythm. It was serve and volley, and the point was over quite quick. Today I got to hit a lot of balls and was very pleased with the way I played.
Well, there we see the bracket that you are in, and next for you is Stefan Edberg, and of course that would be on Tuesday. What do you look for in a match against Stefan?
Well, we played a number of times, and
has he ever beaten you, Jimmy?
He has. He beat me in Memphis this year, earlier this year in February, and he played a very good match against me there. But he's another big, strong, young, no-pressure player, you know, and he comes out and he plays like it, you know, with very relaxed, and he's got a very good serve. He volleys well. His ground strokes are good, so it's going to be a good match.
Got a little special tribute for you. Sit right here. We're going to have that.
I'll
we
stay.
Continue with our live coverage from the U.S. Open in just a moment. James Scott Connors has won the U.S. Open, and of course, tomorrow, Jimmy, you'll blow out 33 candles, yet another birthday cake. But actually, 1952 was a very good year. In fact, we might say it was a vintage year for American tennis players. Our John Tesh has a look back at what was one of the best of years ever.
It was the fall of 52. The GIs were on the move in Korea. Stateside, Hank Williams filled the airwaves, and Bogey and Bacall had it all. General Dwight D. Eisenhower was about to become our 34th president. And it was during that era that eight of America's greatest tennis players were born.
Well, the class of 52, we had an awful lot of good young guys that came up that year. We've been playing against each other since we were about 7 or 8 years old. So it's an old group of guys that have played an awful lot of tennis together.
You know, I look back and I really can't believe that we had that many good guys. I mean, that had to be one of the greatest crop of tennis players I think ever to come out of the United States.
Gottfried, Stockton, Tanner, Solomon, Dibbs, Van Dillen, Sandy Mayer, and the one and only James Scott Connors. How good were these guys? Well, among them, they won over 200 tournaments worth over $18 million. At one time or another, seven of the eight were ranked within the top 10 of tennis. But who could have imagined all this way back when?
Go.
Harold Solomon is the only one of these prodigies whose early career is chronicled in cinema. Sandy Mayer, left, and Jimmy Connors, right, were also born in 1952, as was Brian Gottfried, but Roscoe Tanner was born a year earlier. Eddie Dibbs was another 1951 baby. Likewise, Eric Van Dillen on the left and Dick Stockton, who then was the most talented of the lot.
I was from a small town in Illinois, and Godfrey was from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and Stockton was from New York, and Solomon was from Maryland, and Dibbs was from Florida. So we were a mixture of a lot of places throughout the country, but we all seemed to get together and to play the same events.
I do remember a very, very funny situation. I was in St. Louis, his hometown, so I was playing the 15 and under. And Jimmy's mother came up to me, and she, because I had won the 11 under that year, she said, when are you going to step aside and give my Jimbo a chance?
You look back and you can't believe how young and different you were at that time. I can't believe I was, you know, the major major day was there was whether or not you're going to have an orange or a lemon popsicle, and you know how many hours you're going to swim, and then you play a little tennis, win a match, and you go out that night.
Some are going out in style. Only Jimmy Connors remains a full-time player on the tour, although Harold Solomon plays occasional tournaments. Eddie Dibbs enjoys married life and plays the senior circuit. Fellow Floridian Brian Gottfried coaches and spends time with his family. Roscoe Tanner is in private business out west, as are Mayor Stockton and Van Dillen, yet each is forever linked together by the past.
Each pitcher, you'll remember a story. It's like a time warp. You look at these things and you say, God, that was great then. You know, that was just so much fun.
It was a camaraderie. It's a relationship that has carried over to this day. I mean, those guys are my best friends in tennis, and you know, I hope that they feel that I'm one of their best friends.
I think just from each of us doing so well and the other guy wanting to do as well, if not better, it really you know, spurred us on to greater heights. And the camaraderie and the friendship, I think, made it a lot more enjoyable. If we didn't have that, I don't think it would have been as much fun.
Ah, the years pass too quickly.
They do, way too quickly.
All right, Jimmy, I know you're going to be joining us tomorrow with our live coverage. I want to remind everybody that we're going to be coming on the air tomorrow again at 12:30 p.m. Eastern time. And then, of course, if you cannot see our live tennis coverage for 5.5 hours, we will have a highlight show at 11:30 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow night, updating all the Labor Day activity. Now, again, the main men you're going to be seeing tomorrow, John McEnroe against Tomas